going to deal with Ann Hall and Langford?
So when I become governor.
That may be a tough little situation there.
You're going to deal with them.
I'll call them and I just get these letters that are, that come to me like over Gorsuch, which was back in what, February? I object to them. I just, the other week, I finally got a letter off of it.
Yeah, and it was the same form letter that everybody got, right? As many times as I've written them, I get the same form letter with misinformation, misperceptions. And when I say you're going to deal with them, the voters have to deal with them.
Well, that's in 2020 for Langford.
But Ann Hall.
22 for Langford, 24 Ann Hall.
For Ann Hall. The same movement that is sweeping Oklahoma right now will sweep them out of office. I believe that. I believe that things are so bad in Oklahoma that the people are ready to rise up and to balance this out. We need at least one Democratic legislator in the U.S. Senate. Hopefully, we can get more Democratic Congress people in the House of Representatives. But that's going to be up to the people. It's going to be up to this party to do the work, to educate people, to get them voting, not just registering, right? Getting them educated and inspiring them to get them to vote.
Well, I was kind of thinking on lines of, you know, they supposedly go to file and discuss certain things on what, how they should vote for the state. But I'm thinking there's going to be a conflict of interest. We have a Democrat governor, and them two being Republicans, especially Langford.
Yeah, I ran against Mr. Langford. You know, he's got a great sounding voice, but he's just wrong. And I think,
wrong voice.
Again, I'm depending on the people of the state of Oklahoma to take this state back by voting. There's no other solution. In this system, and this system isn't going anywhere, the legislature's not going, your city council, your school board, your county commissioners, the system isn't going anywhere. Now, I suggest that we can fix it some, we can tweak it, but that system is governed by the people and whether the people vote or not. And I think people are feeling it now. And like
well,
I said,
they don't represent everyday people. They don't.
No, they don't. But we got to get those everyday people to vote them out. And that's the challenge to the party. That's the challenge to us as Democrats. We got to give them people who do represent them, and we've got to give them a message that is something different from God's gays and guns. We have literally got to say, no, this is about health care and Medicaid expansion, and it's about treatment instead of incarceration. And it's about roads and bridges for all areas. It's about environmental issues. It's about tribes having the ability to have their own sovereignty and do things on their land that helps their economic improvement. It's about so many things that they have been messaging about successfully compared to us as Democrats. And we've got to start our messaging in a way that resonates with them. I tell people, as a member of the Democratic Party, I literally had to fight the party about a gag order that they were trying to put on us as a party, where we couldn't talk about immigration, we couldn't talk about marijuana, the death penalty. It's two more things. But all of those things make up our base. So we're like, well, what can we talk about? Well, who are we if we can't talk about those things? You know, we can't allow them to do the messaging around women's reproductive rights. This women's reproductive rights is not a bill. Like she said, Planned Parenthood is more than about abortion. It's not even about abortion. It's about contraceptive. Let's talk about early and appropriate child sex education. Let's talk about making contraception available to women so they don't have unintended pregnancy.